最後まで残るんだ。You have slain an enemy.
What up, humans? Kurumi here, and welcome to the Mobile Legends Bootcamp. In this video, we are going to talk about the Burst Mage hero, Eudora. Eudora has a good set of Area of Effect, Stun, and Burst skills. Our Lightning Sorceress, Eudora, is a mage hero. I consider Eudora as a Burst Mage not just for team fights but for solo killing as well, since her skills can swiftly kill an enemy with just one combo. Not only that, she can also stun an enemy for more than a second to prolong the target's agony. Now, let me share some tips and tricks on how to use Eudora based on my experience. We will also teach you some combos and techniques on the latter part of this bootcamp. But before that, let me explain her skills one by one for further understanding. Eudora's passive, Superconductor, lets Eudora's skills inflict the target with a Superconductor debuff. Upon dealing damage to enemies with Eudora's skills, they become inflicted with the Superconductor debuff. While the enemy has this debuff, your skills will either deal more damage, or it will have additional effects when casted to an enemy with Superconductor debuff. The effects depend which skill you will use while the debuff is in effect. We will tackle on that later on each skills. Eudora's first skill, Forked Lightning, lets Eudora cast a Forked Lightning to deal damage to enemies within the fan-shaped area in front of her. Enemies hit by the Forked Lightning will receive a certain amount of magic damage. When the enemy has the Superconductor debuff when you use this skill, the damage of this skill will be calculated with a magic defense reduction, depending on the level of this skill. We will further discuss that later on the tips and tricks section. Eudora's second skill, Electric Arrow, lets Eudora strike an enemy with a bolt of lightning. Enemy hit will receive certain amount of magic damage and will stun the target for a short period. When this skill is used on an enemy under the Superconductor debuff, then the duration of the stun will be longer. Eudora's ultimate skill, Thunderstruck, lets Eudora summon a great storm of lightning. Enemies hit by this skill will receive a massive amount of magic damage. The damage varies on the area of effect. The main target will receive greater damage than the enemies beside him. When the targets have the Superconductor debuff, they will receive 15% more damage from this skill. There are so many items that you can buy for Eudora. You can focus on items that grants magic power, magic penetration, and extra magic damage on your skill. You can focus on the death build if you want burst damage dealing with your skills. You can also focus on Eudora's build if you prefer to be roaming support with your stun, but still deals burst damage that will definitely erase the target's existence. But let's focus on the Kurumi way further. As for starting item, you might want to consider Arcane Boots. Arcane Boots grants her additional magic penetration and movement speed. Magic penetration will make you deal more damage with your skills. Buying magic items, such as Lightning Truncheon, will help you deal more burst damage. This item gives you magic power, mana, and cooldown reduction. Its unique passive will deal magic damage to your target, and two other enemies when you use a skill. This unique passive has a short cooldown. You can consider buying Holy Crystal. This item grants a huge amount of magic power. Its unique passive increases your magic attack by a percentage. The percentage scales with your level. You also might want to consider Divine Glaive. This item grants magic power. Its unique effect grants a certain percentage of magic penetration on your skills. In addition, its unique passive grants extra magic penetration when your HP is above a certain amount. You might want to consider Fleeting Time. This item grants you additional magic power and cooldown reduction. Its unique passive grants your ultimate skill cooldown to be instantly reduced by a certain percentage after an elimination or an assist. Lastly, you can consider Blood Wings. This grants you magic power and health points. Its unique passive adds health points for every points of magic power added to your hero. The additional health points can help you survive in team fights. The item build for Eudora really depends on the enemy's lineup. So make sure you read each item's description so you can adapt in-game. One of the best spells to be used on Eudora is Flame Shot. Using this spell will knock back enemies hit, reduce their movement speed, and will deal certain amount of magic damage. This will be helpful especially when enemies try approaching you. You can also consider Sprint. This grants you additional movement speed which decays over time. This reduces your time controlled and make you immune from slowing effects for a short period. This is really helpful to chase enemies or escape death. In my opinion, the best emblem set to be used is the Custom Mage Emblem set. Custom Mage Emblem could provide extra stats according to your needs as a magic damager. Set agility to its max level because it can give you additional movement speed. Higher movement speed means higher chance to chase enemies or escape death. Setting observation to max level will provide additional magic penetration on your skills. Higher magic penetration deals more magic damage to enemies. That means your skills will be more explosive. Get magic worship to deal more magic damage to the enemies. When dealing damage that is more than a certain percentage of target's max HP for 3 times in 5 seconds, the target will receive a burning effect. This burning effect burns the target for 3 times. This effect has a cooldown of 12 seconds. Set first skill to max level first. Prioritizing this makes the base damage of this skill higher. That means the enemy will be receiving more damage. Prioritize second skill less since first skill is what you need for damage dealing. Always upgrade your ultimate skill when available for upgrading. Eudora doesn't have any mobility skills. So for the Kurumi way, we recommend that you stay behind the team fight and better pick your spells well since this can help you survive in team fights. Your skills have a decent range. So with that, you can still cast your skills even without going inside team fights. Eudora's passive skill is what you need to boost your skill's damage. The lightning indicator above the enemy's head shows that the debuff is in effect. Enemies inflicted with the superconductor debuff will boost the effects of your next skill. Each of your skills have different effects when casting skills to enemies with a debuff. If you cast your first skill on targets with the superconductor debuff, it will grant additional debuff effect of magic defense reduction along with its damage. If you cast your second skill on a target with the superconductor debuff, the stun duration will last longer. Lastly, if you cast your ultimate skill on enemies with the superconductor debuff, it will deal more burst damage just enough to bury their dead bodies in no time. Eudora's first skill is what you need for burst damage. The damage of this skill is not something you should underestimate. This skill in the late game could almost tear off half of the enemy's health points. You might be confused if this skill's description that says it reduces magic defense of the target. Well, yes, it does reduce the magic defense, but that is only applicable to your first skill's damage. We will show you what we mean by that. Take a look on the scenario on the left. We will use our second skill then our ultimate skill. Take note of its damage. Now, on the right, let's use first skill first then our ultimate skill. As you can see, the damage is just the same compared with our scenario on the left. That only means that the magic defense reduction is only applicable for the first skill's instance. The one on the left is the damage without the superconductor debuff. Now the on the right is the damage with the superconductor debuff. As you can see, the magic defense reduction is really only applied to our first skill's damage. Eudora's second skill is what you need to stun your target. This is really helpful, especially when ganking other lanes. Depending on your goal at the spur of moment, you may use your second skill first to stun the enemy and give them the superconductor debuff to deal more devastating effects with your other skills. Or, you can use your other skills or spell like Flame Shot first to give the debuff, then use your second skill for a longer stun duration. Again, this depends on your goal at the moment if it's either you need more damage or you need longer stun duration. So better practice your playmaking decisions during matches. Eudora's ultimate skill is what you need to destroy enemies' lives. With the super duper extreme burst damage it deals, one hit would definitely make the enemy go back to his mother's womb immediately, wishing he was never been born. But in serious a note, this skill is the real deal. Just make sure to use this skill when the target has the superconductor debuff. This is to ensure that your ultimate skill will deal burst damage to its full potential. Here we go again with our experiments. We will test some scenarios against Eudora's extreme burst combo and skills. As you may have noticed, Eudora's ultimate skill takes time before it punishes the enemy. So we will show you heroes that could fearlessly dodge Eudora's ultimate skill. First, let's have Lancelot. Lancelot's second skill makes him invulnerable for a short period. With the long wait for the lightning to strike upon Lancelot, he can still do some clutch plays and dodge your ultimate skill. Next up, we also have Hayabusa. Let's see if he can dodge Eudora's ultimate skill. As you can see, Hayabusa is also untargetable while his ultimate skill is ongoing. Next up, we have Ling. Ling's ultimate skill also makes him untargetable while it is ongoing. So in short, heroes with skills that makes them untargetable could easily counter Eudora's ultimate skill, just as long as they use it at the right timing. Next, we have Zask. We all know that Zask's ultimate skill makes him ride inside his nightmaric spawn. Let's see if it will damage Zask. As you can see, Zask and his spawn didn't receive any damage. So try to avoid using your ultimate skill when the enemy Zask haven't used his ultimate yet. Last but not the least, we have Nana. We all know that Nana's passive makes her a cutie little creature that is untargetable. As you can see, even with our Omega level destructive combo, Nana could just easily smile and run away. So if even you are against Nana, just make sure to chase her even after you've released your combo, because you'll never know if she has her passive on cooldown or not. In terms of her combo, we recommend this combo to achieve her skill's damage full potential. Let's tackle first on the combo during the early game without your ultimate skill. First, use your second skill to stun the target. This will also inflict the superconductor debuff on them. Then, use your first skill. Because of the superconductor, the enemy will be inflicted with a magic defense reduction debuff, making your first skill deal more damage. Then, if you have flame shot, use it to further deal damage to the target. This will ensure that the target will either recall back to base, or dig his own grave by still staying in the lane. Next up, let's have her combo when she has her ultimate skill. First, use your second skill to stun the target. This will also inflict the superconductor debuff on them. Then, use your first skill. Because of the superconductor, the enemy will be inflicted with a magic defense reduction debuff, making your first skill deal more damage. Then, use your ultimate skill. This will further make the body of your target turn to dust in no time. Then, if you have flame shot, use it to ensure the enemy's agonizing pain will end swiftly. Then if the enemy is still alive with whatever reason, you have can deal basic attacks and wait for your skills to cool down, or better run for your life. Additional tip. I know some humans would ask about Eudora's mana problems. Well, guess what? You are a free human to buy mana items, such as demon shoes. This is to ensure that your mana doesn't deplete easily. Just like on this scenario, because of mana problems, all we can do is just bid farewell to the enemy and go back as sad as possible. The tips I mentioned are just some of the ways you can use Eudora. This video just guides you on how to use Eudora, the Kurumi way. We would like to thank our Wakandian brother, Rakuten, for being our lab rat for this boot camp. You can search for him in-game and tell him how much you appreciate him, willing to sacrifice his pride and honor to be a test subject. Do not forget to like and share this video. Also subscribe to our channel for more contents by clicking on the subscribe and bell button. For our skin giveaway events, check out the community tab for the giveaway event post. We have our Ko-fi account just in case you want to donate us some Ko-fi funds. Check our Ko-fi link on the description of this video. Please only trust boot camp videos from our official accounts. See you on the next Mobile Legends boot camp. Cheers.